Well, there is a growing memorial this morning outside Manchester's YWCA where police say a man shot and killed his own son before committing suicide. It allegedly happened during a supervised visit between Mooney Savon and his 9-year-old son Joshua. Andy Hirschberger joins us live at the YWCA with the latest developments in all of this. And Andy, we understand there was a domestic violence order of protection issued against Savon.
Well, yes, Sean. Investigators say Savon had a troubled relationship with the boy's mother for years and has threatened to hurt her and the boy before.
From what we know right now, no one saw this coming.
It was just after 10 Sunday morning at the Manchester YWCA when authorities say 54-year-old Mooney Savon pulled out a gun during a supervised visit with his 9-year-old son Joshua and opened fire.
He did produce a firearm. Shot his son several times and then turned it on himself and eventually killed himself.
Investigators say Savon has been separated from his son's mother for several years and the relationship had been troubled. News 9 has learned that there was an active domestic violence protection order against him.
He's made threats in the past to harm himself, his son, and his son's mother, and unfortunately he carried through with that today.
A counselor who was in the room at the YWCA was able to escape. Authorities say the YWCA does have a handheld metal detector and that it had been used on Savon in the past, but not this time.
When they've had the money, they've been able to hire police officers to be in there to provide security. My understanding is because of budget cuts, they haven't had that money recently, so there was no other security in the building.
Savon's visit with his son was videotaped. Authorities will look at that evidence, along with the firearm that was used. Neighbors at the Manchester home where Savon lived alone tell News 9 they are in disbelief. Many others are looking for ways to cope with the tragedy.
There's a lot of sadness and also anger on the part of everyone involved that a father would take his son's life for no other reason other than to apparently spite his mother.
The YWCA has released a statement reading in part, "We are deeply saddened by the tragic loss of life that occurred at the YWCA New Hampshire today. Our thoughts and prayers go out to the families and friends of all those involved in this incident." Reporting live in Manchester, I'm Andy Hirschberger, WMUR News 9.